Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the second episode of Teams with Tony. So today we're going to be looking at an application called Bookings. Bookings is something that Microsoft integrated with Teams and the Office 365 suite not long ago. I wanted to point this out because I'm actually using Microsoft Bookings myself, and I thought that it would be of value to some other customers out there. And I wanted to give you a quick rundown of what it is, how it looks, and give you kind of an example of what it, how you can use it in your business today. So as you notice here on the screen, I've logged into my Office 365 application or tenant here. And you notice, depending on your license SKU, these are the applications that I actually have access to. And up top is Microsoft Bookings. I do want to point out that Bookings is available, from what I can understand, it's available within every enterprise Office 365 SKU, as well as the business SKUs. So if you've got E1, E3, E5, and any kind of the business standard, business premium, and business essential SKUs, so it will be available. Now, for the purposes of this demo, it's already set up for me, and I've been using it, but there are a few things that need to be done in the back end to enable this for users in the organization. So just keep that in mind that there is some quick setup things that need to be done. But for the purposes of this demo, those are already done. So now that I'm in here, I wanted to show you that Bookings is available as one of the applications. So if I click on that, I can access it. But I want to go into Microsoft Teams and do it to show you what that looks like. And do so, all you have to do is click on the three dots, and you'll notice that Bookings shows up. So once I click on Bookings, it shows me, the calendar that I last worked on, from within Microsoft Teams. I will also minimize this and bring it up from within here to show you, because what it does is it opens up Outlook and then eventually takes you into the Bookings application here. You can also get to that from within Microsoft Teams. And it sometimes takes a little while to load based on whatever the integration is. Sometimes a little bit slow. But once it comes up, it shows you the calendar you were last working on. And then you can make some changes within here. But most of the settings and changes that you're going to want to do are going to be within the web application. So if I were to click on this, it's going to go back into that page that I was on. So I'm just going to minimize that for a minute. And so from within here, for the purposes of this demo, I've created an additional calendar here called Teams with Tony. And in here, I've added one of my colleagues, Stephanie Baskerville, who's actually on the line with me now, sitting quietly. She's from our marketing team. But I've added her as a part of this particular this booking calendar. So, one of the great things about this particular application is that if I think of some use cases, think of like any kind of use case where you have to book time against a calendar, or maybe you want to hand out your calendar access to either customers or vendors for them to see when your availability is. And this is a great way to do that, especially for some small businesses just getting started. This is a great way to be able to do it. So you can add different staff members within your organization. You can create different services for the calendar to book time against, and then even associate different costs with those. So again, Stephanie's here for the staff. If we look at some of the services in here, I've used an example of, I've got an initial consult for 1 hour, and I've got a haircut here for 1 hour, and I put a default price of $25. So interesting things you can do to book time against this calendar. And going into the booking page, once you create the calendar or the booking page, it gives you the URL that you can pass out to your customers or vendors, and then you can open this to make changes to it. So if I go into Microsoft Teams, after I've created some of those settings, now you'll see that my calendar here shows different appointments I had in my default calendar, but I can go ahead in here and look for a different calendar that I might want to work on. And so in this case, I'll choose existing booking calendar and then view all calendars in my org. In this case, I know the names or the name of it. Whoops. Teams with Tony. Enter. Let's see if it finds it. And it found it. Perfect. Well, so we'll give that a second for it to load. And while that's loading, I'll go back over here and see if there's other settings that I can go through for you. Again, there's a number of settings you can do to make your page and customize your page to make it look more professional here. Again, adding a logo is a great idea. Changing the color scheme. So I've changed it to blue in this case, because actually ProServe IT just gone through another branding and our color has now changed from red to blue. And I want to give a big kudos to the marketing team for that, for the new branding and logos that they've done for ProServe IT. They've done a great job. As we scroll down, you can set, you know, some of the policies around some of the services that you offer. And here the default would be a 30-minute calendar item. And then once you go back in here, open published page, you'll see this is what your customers or vendors would see if they're going to your page. You know, if they click on whatever day it might be. On this day, I've got a haircut. So on the September 23rd, we've got one at 3 o'clock. We'll choose Stephanie. She's going to perform that haircut. Choose 3 o'clock. And I'll say TCAP, TCAP. Address no, and can I get a men's haircut? And we'll book it and let's see what goes. So that should just take a second. And while that's working, we'll scroll back over here into the Microsoft Teams platform. And it's finally found that calendar and should load it here shortly. Again, I think this is just one of the different features and functionalities that, you know, Microsoft Teams offers that I think is good for small businesses, especially if you're starting out, you know, a new company or something. Microsoft 365 suite has a lot to offer for you and your small business, at least, you know, getting jump started. And there we go. So now we've got Teams with Tony. We've got different staff members. You can show the calendars that are associated with them. And did we create one for the, okay, so this is the 22nd. Let's move over to the 23rd and see if we can find the one we created. Yep. And so now I can see the haircut that I created for Stephanie in here. And now since Stephanie should have access to this, she can go and view that and see what the appointments are that are scheduled for her. I think that'll probably just about wrap it up. I just wanted to give you guys a quick view into the bookings application. I thought it was something that was a really good kind of, good featured item to use with Microsoft Teams and even the Office 365 platform. So stay tuned. Next time, we're going to talk about Planner, which is also integrated with Teams. And interestingly enough, it has a new name. So stay tuned. Please don't forget to like and subscribe below. If you like this, we're going to be doing this on a regular basis. So stay tuned next time. Thanks, guys.